So, what are you doing with your life? Hmm? How is your practice going? How is your daily reflection? Then Alex, I heard about it. Huh?
I did up to the point. To the point when I went on the computer, and then I was it. At the end, around 11 in the morning, end of my daily reflection. From the morning.
Don't you think it is important, especially, you know, I mean, how much garbage you put into your head, huh? This the Kilesas don't want to see, how much garbage we put in our head. I mean, it is the basic, huh? Why don't you get it? Yeah? It is the first step of investigation. Hmm? After investigation, dukkha vedana, I mean, painful feelings, huh? I mean, the daily reflection to know what we are doing, why we are doing, and what are the results of it, huh? Right? How can I help you if you don't do what I say? Hmm? Hmm? Then Dennis, huh? You don't seem to do the daily reflection either, huh? And Martin, are you doing it now every day?
Yeah, since every day.
It is, it's really, I mean, all, do we really want to wander around in the darkness, huh? I mean, if we don't do it, if we don't know what we are doing, if we don't know the results of our doing, yeah, be it the action, bodily action, or be it the mental action, or be it the speech action, huh? If we don't know, you know, I mean, why do we say the things, huh? Why do we give a comment, yeah, when somebody says something? What comes before? What comes before? I mean, this, you know, this kind of reflection is so important in our daily practice, yeah? Because when we do investigation of the body, we have to ask the same questions. Huh? When a feeling comes up, yeah, we have to ask what comes before it. Yeah, what came before it, and what came before that, and what came before that. What is the stone then, you know, that causes the avalanche? But the Kilesas don't like it, I understand that, so they find all sorts of reasons. Now I'm too tired, I can't remember, yeah. Huh? They find all sorts of reasons, you know, to protect themselves, yeah. It's a self-protection mechanism of the Kilesas. They don't want us to know. It is like, you know, the Kilesas, I mean, did I say it before? The Kilesas are like thieves, yeah. And the thieves don't like, you know, if somebody looks at, you know, how they do their thieving. Huh? Hmm? They steal our attention, yeah? And they don't want, you know, any kind of methods you know, that can undermine the power of the Kilesas. They don't like it. And that's why we don't do it. Not because we are, yeah. Do you hear the Kilesas talking? Huh? I mean, they're all there in our head. Oh, yeah, it's so difficult. Oh, yeah, oh, I'm so tired. Oh, I've done enough. Yeah, you're a good boy. Yeah, and so on. It's the Kilesas talking. The Dhamma never talks like that. Huh? The Dhamma always says, go on, go on, go on, go on. Yeah? Because it wants, you know, it wants sooner or later, it wants... wants to get on the throne, you know, and determine what we are doing, yeah. But the Kilesas, you know, have the upper hand at the moment, and we need to dethrone them. Hmm? And if you don't know what the Kilesas are, huh, If we have not yet understood, you know, the power of the kilesas, or if we have not understood, you know, how the kilesas manipulate us all the time, then we are helpless. Then we go from one life to the next life, to the next life, and to the next life. Yeah? You want that? Huh? You want to be born again and go through all the troubles, through all the shit that we have gone through? Huh? You need some motivation, you know, huh? In order to fight, being able to fight the kilesas. The kilesas are not going to hell, but they lead us to hell, yeah? They also could lead us, can lead us to heaven, yeah? But that is much more difficult, yeah? For the kilesas who constantly want things, yeah? They don't like to give up things, yeah? But we can train them, yeah? We can train them to go to heaven. But it is also, yeah? It's just one of the realms, yeah? Of existence. And if you remember, hamster wheel, yeah? Running, not going anywhere, huh? I mean, if you enjoy this life so much, yeah? I mean, I wonder why have you become monks, yeah? Huh? And how long did you train to become monks? How long were you helping monks in your previous lives? How often did you support monks? How often, you know, how many lives did you use, you know, to be able to become a monk in a very comfortable situation? Huh? And you want to waste that time? You want to waste that opportunity that you have right now? Huh? It's so difficult. Ah. You have to fight every moment, huh? I mean, from the morning you get up, yeah? I mean, you fight. Okay, I don't want to think. I don't want to remember what I dream. I don't want to think about it. I want to stay with the Buddha, or I want to stay with the breath, yeah? And whenever, you know, during all our activities, we don't have to think. During all our activities, we can stay with the Buddha, or we can stay with the breath. And don't let the kilesas overwhelm us. If you yet don't know, you know, what the kilesas are, how the kilesas work, you know, just sit down, you know, and do samadhi, yeah, practice samadhi, huh? Close your eyes, yeah, put your right hand into the left hand, huh? Close your eyes, sit comfortable, and then say, for the next 1 hour, I just want to stay with the Buddha. And whatever else comes into the mind, whatever memory comes into the mind, whatever thought comes into mind, is brought up by the kilesas. Huh? And then you can see it so clearly. Huh? Oh, I'm tired, I'm it's hurting so much, and so on, and so on, and so on. Oh, I've done didn't enough. Oh, this was good. Even that, yeah? Even all these comments, yeah? Starts on Pindapat, yeah? I mean, it starts in the morning, yeah? When we don't want to get up, when we just want to, oh, I'm so tired, you know, let's go. Let's sleep on the other ear, yeah? Let's turn around and sleep. Tomorrow I train again, yeah? Yeah, I mean, who is talking? Who is talking? It's the kilesas who talk like that. The kilesas who don't want. The kilesas who are lazy. They don't want to fight. they don't want to strain. They just want to have a good time. Yeah? They just want to play with all the senses that are around. Yeah? And they want to play around with the thoughts, you know, and the memories, yeah, the memories of the past, yeah, and the thoughts, you know, projecting something in the future. Oh, when I'm enlightened, I'm going to do this. You're not enlightened. Actually, you know, I mean, the light that shines very bright, you know, I mean, your light of Dhamma, is it so bright, you know? I mean, it seems to be quite dark, yeah? There's not enough power, yeah? I mean, your battery is quite empty. The battery for your light, yeah? I mean, you have to sharpen. You have to sharpen sati. And the other thing that is so difficult, yeah? I mean, the one thing is, you know, I mean, the daily reflection that is so difficult and it goes against the grain, yeah? The other thing that goes against the grain is when we sit in samadhi and do our putto or observe the breath at the tip of the nose, yeah? Knowing, yeah? Developing the sati, that is so difficult, that is so, you know, against the grain, yeah, of the kilesas that, yeah, okay, you know, after a while they get used to it, they stay with the Buddha, or they stay with the breath, that's fine, yeah. And while they stay with the Buddha, or while they stay with the breath, they find their ways, you know, and thinking in the background, and doing all these things in the background, and we are not aware of it. In the moment we stop meditation, they come out again, yeah? I mean, they just hide for a little bit, you know? I mean, just working, you know, working themselves in the background. What we need to do is, you know, I mean, to to know every moment of our meditation, yeah? No matter if it is invested in meditation or investigation, know what is going on, yeah? Know what is going on in the heart. Know, yeah. Know if the Buddha is fast. Know if the Buddha is slow. Know if the Buddha is deep or shallow. Yeah. And the same thing for the breath. Is it the beginning of the breath? Is it the in-breath or is it the out-breath? And in the beginning, then is the in-breath longer than the out-breath or shorter than the out-breath? And so on. Yeah. Where is the turning point between the in-breath and the out-breath? Huh? Is the breath deep or is it shallow? Is it short? Yeah. Not to manipulate the breath or not to manipulate the Buddha, yeah, but to observe it, yeah? To know every moment, every single mind moment, you know, how the Buddha is or how the breath is at this moment. And of course, yes, that goes against the grain. That is, yeah, both, the daily reflection to, I can't remember. We try to remember, you know, if we really can't, you know, then we just go on to the next step, yeah, that we can remember. What came then? Yeah, okay, yeah, this I remember, huh? And then go on. And if we do that, yeah, if we really do it wholeheartedly, then after a year or after 1.5 years, you know, I mean, we see everything that is going on during the day. Everything, yeah. We see the slightest movement of the heart, yeah. We see, you know, the thoughts that come up, you know, that we weren't aware of it even, yeah? Even while we are, you know, while we are doing our chankram, yeah. We can see it, yeah. Because we need this access to the memory that is not in our brain, but the memory that is in our heart. How do you think, you know, if the memory is only in our brain, how can we remember, you know, previous lives, yeah? The memory of the previous lives or the memory of the previous happenings or of our karma, you know, of previous life is all stored in the citta, yeah? And this is what we want to access. We want to access the citta. And the first thing is to make the citta calm. Yeah? If the citta is completely perturbed, yeah, by thoughts and memories, I mean, we don't see. Yeah? We can't see anything. So the first thing is to make it clear. And to make it clear, being awake, yeah? not half drowsy, yeah? But being completely awake, yeah? Knowing any moment, you know, what is going on. Huh? That is when we are awake, yeah? And it is the same thing, you know, when we do investigation of the body or when we do investigation of dukkha vedana. We have to be awake, yeah? Probably dukkha vedana, I mean, is the most easiest thing for us because, I mean, the pain doesn't go away. But what are you doing? Huh? But what are we doing, you know, when dukkha vedana comes up? Ah, it's enough, yeah. I mean, let's rest a little bit, yeah? We don't want to fight with dukkha vedana. It's the same thing, yeah? I mean, be it the daily reflection, be it, you know, fighting with dukkha vedana or or fighting with, you know, knowing every moment of our meditation, yeah? Knowing of the Buddha, knowing of the breath. Hmm? Otherwise, just bury yourself, you know, and hope that the next life is better. Just hope, yeah. Huh? Next life should be better, yeah. Oh, we did so much, yeah. Hope is not one of the enlightenment. I didn't hear that, you know, when we look at the enlightenment factors, I mean, hope is not one of them. Huh? Huh? What is it? Virya, effort, yeah? Constant effort. Samadhi, upekha. What else? Huh? Yeah? I never can remember all the quotes. Yeah? Sati, of course, sati, samadhi, upekha, yeah. And what? Effort, yeah, virya, piti, yeah. Piti is important, you know, but how can we reach a piti? Yeah? And what was the other one? Tranquility. Hmm? Yeah. I mean, that is what, you know, for samadhi, you know, that's what we want to reach, yeah. And how tranquil is your mind when you do, yeah, samadhi? Huh? Pity is important, yeah. I mean, we feel the pity, you know, when we enter samadhi, yeah. When the mind for the first time is completely quiet. And we are awake, we are not asleep, yeah. The mind can be completely, really, rather quiet, you know, when we are half dozing off, yeah. That's not where pity arises. Pity arises, you know, when really everything stops, when the thought stops, and when the memories that comes up, you know, stop coming up, yeah. That's, you know, where pity comes, yeah. Or then joy, yeah, or or tranquility, or calmness, yeah, stillness. And can you attain to it? Huh? And it virya is the thing, yeah. I mean, how often did I say, you know, I mean, that laziness is not an enlightenment factor. Huh? I mean, you tend to believe that laziness, you know, not doing this, not doing that, oh, I'm not interested, you know, I don't care. I don't care is also not an enlightenment factor. Huh? Because I don't care is just pushing things away. Huh? Not being able, not wanting to see these things. Huh? Not being interested. Yeah, it's different from I don't care. Whatever the kilesas are bringing up, I'm not interested. Not I don't care. Huh? I don't care, you know, it is, you know, not paying attention. Not being interested is knowing what is coming up, but not interested in what the kilesas are bringing up. Yeah? So there's quite a difference. Huh? We care a lot, yeah? And we care especially about, you know, what is happening in the heart. Because that's where we want to go. We want to have access to the heart, yeah? To the citta. And we have to go, you know, we have to go through a lot of rubble, through a lot of shit, you know, through a lot of very difficult feelings and very difficult memories, yeah? We have to see them, you know, we have to recognize them. Not, I don't care, you know, I don't care whatever comes up, you know, comes up, yeah? No. We have to recognize them for what they are, you know, and then put them aside, yeah? And the more, you know, just like I said before, I mean, when we want to clean up our attic that we have used all the trash, you know, put into the attic or into the cellar, you know, I mean, and the door nearly bulges, you know, because all the things that are in there, the moment we open the lock, you know, I mean, everything, you know, comes rushing towards us, yeah? So, yeah, okay, see one thing at a time, okay, this is this, put it aside, yeah, not being interested in it anymore, yeah, but recognizing it, what it is, yeah, knowing, okay, putting it aside, knowing, putting it aside, knowing, put it aside, until there's nothing more, anymore in the cellar, yeah, and then we do the cleaning work, Then we take our Hoover, you know, and put out, you know, and Hoover out all the dust, yeah? And then we take, you know, a wet cloth, you know, and clean it up. And then, you know, only then do we see, you know, all these stains that are in the floors and in the windows and so on the wall, yeah? And then stain by stain, you know, we clean the heart until it is completely polished. And the important thing is we don't let anything anymore into the heart, yeah? Now we do, yeah. It's the same thing, you know, for lay people who come here, you know, for a week or for 2 weeks, and they're really, you know, and the heart is really quiet, and then they go out into the world, you know, and then, you know, the senses bombard them, you know, and when they come back, you know, I mean, the heart is full of it, yeah, again. And it takes, you know, just these for three. How long was it, yeah, Carlos? 1 week, you know, how much, yeah? I mean, you have to sweep for 3 days, you know, to get it, yeah, to get back to the previous result, yeah? And now think about, you know, being 3 months, or, you know, most of the lay people, you know, come once a year for a month, yeah? I mean, how much can you take in 9 months, yeah? When I remember the first time, I don't know which retreat, was it the third retreat or fourth retreat I took, you know, I was really, really, really calmed down, yeah? And then I went, you know, then I went, I need to make some copies, you know, in the nearby town, yeah? And I thought, this is crazy, just going, you know, just one drop, you know, I mean, all these sense inputs that come into, yeah? The sights, you know, the hearing, the smelling, and so on, yeah? Wow. It's like, you know, you're bombarded, yeah? But we don't know the difference, you know, if you don't know the tranquility, yeah, of the heart. If you don't know, you know, what it is like, you know, when the heart is completely unperturbed, yeah? So we don't know what the dangers of the things are that are lurking outside. Or we don't see the difference, and we say, oh, it's the same, yeah? No, it's not the same. And only, you know, only if you get rid of the kilesas, cut down on the kilesas, then when you go out, nothing of these things, you know, perturb you anymore, yeah? Because you removed all all the thorns, you know, that were in your skin where the kilesas are playing on. Once you remove them all, you know, I mean, there's no kilesas playing on these thorns anymore, yeah? And yeah, they try to press it, but there's no pain anymore because there's no thorn and there's no poison in it anymore. That is the way of investigation. Through investigation, especially through the investigation of the body, we get rid of all these thoughts, yeah, of greed and hate, yeah. First we reduce it to half, yeah, and then we completely get rid of it, yeah. And with each thought we take out, you know, this thought doesn't grow back. So we have to do this investigation of the body. We can start with the investigation, you know, looking at the life, and that is something, looking at the life, looking at death, yeah? I mean, we are about to die. Every one of us is about to die. We can all die today, you know, tonight, yeah? All of us. There's no guarantee that we are alive tomorrow, yeah? Or, you know, we can die in 10 years or in 15 years or in 50 years or something like that, yeah? We don't know. So to put any kind of effort on tomorrow, you know, I mean, it is wrong. Because that is, yeah, I mean, when you look at the German phrase, that is just laziness. What you can do today, don't put it on tomorrow, yeah? You, where are the German speaking? Heute, morgen, nur nicht heute, sagen alle faulen Leute. Huh? Huh? Tomorrow, but not today. It's the saying of all the people who are lazy. Huh? So, think about the life, think about, you know, I mean, just about the human life, yeah? How long did it take you to be able to use this body? How much training was there? Training to walk, training to talk, training to read and write, training to think, yeah? Until the body, you know, was able, until you could use the body, yeah? 15 years, 16 years, yeah? With 16 years, some people start working, yeah? I mean, most of us, you know, went to the higher schools or universities, yeah? And then started to work at with 22 and 23, when we are completely, when we have full strength, yeah? And how long do we have the full strength as a human being? 30 years, yeah? With 45 or 48, you know, I mean, the body starts to decay. In the beginning, very slowly, once in a while, you know, and then we turn close to 60, and then it becomes much, much more often, yeah? And then it turns to 70 and becomes really heavy, and then it stays on for a little while, you know, until the last breath is gone out of the body. Between in 60 and 70, the decay is very, very rapidly, yeah? But before that, you know, with 45, you know, I mean, it starts once in a while, we notice it, you know, but we don't have the same strength as a 30-year-old one, yeah? And we realize that with 50, yeah? We do realize that, you know, when we become 50, we don't have the same strength, you know, and we don't have the same power anymore. The energy is gone, yeah? And with 60, it's even less, you know, and between 60 and 70, I mean, it really starts to decay, you know, also the inner organs, you know, start to decay, you know, they're just, I mean, they reach their lifetime, yeah? So things are not working anymore. So, I mean, think about it, you know, I mean, if you think, you know, this human life is so great, yeah, I mean, yeah, 15 years of training, yeah, 30 years of full strength, for most of the people, yeah, now some people are handicapped since the beginning, yeah, but that is the result of their karma of previous lives, yeah. But most of us, you know, I mean, can use the body full strength, you know, for 30 years, and then it slowly starts to decay. Yeah, that's human life in a nutshell. Huh? And if you think, you know, that is fun, you know, you want some more, I mean, that is completely up to you, yeah. I mean, you're free to choose whatever you want to. And if you think that this human life is so full of sukha, so full of happiness, so full of pleasure, and then you probably are in the wrong place, eh? I mean, you have to realize the first noble truth of dukkha, yeah? Realize the dukkha of the body first, yeah? Each time, you know, I mean, the body, you know, doesn't move very well, you know, or there's some pain, or there's some pain, or there's hunger, or there's thirst, or things like that. Remember, yeah? Or you need to go to the toilet, yeah? You relieve yourself, yeah? I mean, it's dukkha. Tell yourself, okay, first noble truth, dukkha. And whenever an unpleasant feeling comes up, dukkha, yeah? Remind yourself, yeah? I mean, to see, you know, that our life is full of dukkha. Yeah? Most of us, you know, I mean, oh yeah, I'm, when you see, you know, or when I remember my previous life, I mean, you just have a very happy moment during the day, and the whole day is made, yeah? And we don't see the dukkha of the rest of the day. Because, I mean, the sukha that we experience, oh, it's so much, you know, I mean, we just float through the day, yeah? I mean, just like being in the seventh heaven, yeah? But then, you know, then the dukkha comes and the same thing happens, yeah? I know, no matter, you know, if there are some pleasant moments, you know, during the day, I mean, we're just deep diving, you know, in our heart, yeah? Oh, it's so difficult. Remember all these times, yeah? Remember the times, you know, when you grew up, yeah? Remember the times when you went to school, huh? Remember the adulthood, yeah? And the next life you have to do the same thing if you become a human being, yeah? And a human being, yeah, sooner or later we have to become a human being if we want to jump out of the hamster wheel, yeah? If you want to find the door. Yeah? You have to become a human being again. Remember that? Huh? Most, yeah, it is very difficult, I don't know if it is possible, in the deva realm to jump out. Yeah? And the Lord Buddha said, you know, I mean, the human realm is a jumping point. because we have sukha and dukkha at, you know, at the same time. I mean, the devas, you know, mostly have sukha, have happiness, you know, I mean, they're happy, yeah, most of the time. Of course, they have dukkha, but, you know, it is so seldom, yeah. And when we look at the people, you know, who seem to be happy, you know, they don't want to change anything. We only want to change things, you know, if we have enough dukkha. And if we can't see the dukkha, I mean, we don't want to change our way of behavior. We don't want to put more effort into our practice if we don't see the dukkha. So please, yeah, use this as a motivation to see the dukkha. Every moment in your daily life, and, you know, the daily reflection actually helps that, yeah, to see the dukkha in our life, yeah, in our daily, yeah, life. See the uncomfortable feeling, you know, that comes up, yeah, see the strain, see the bodily dukkha, see the mental dukkha, yeah. See it and realize, first noble truth, yeah. Huh? And what is the cause of the dukkha? The second noble truth, yeah. Wanting, desire, yeah. Desiring to be, desiring not to be, desiring to want this, and the desire not to want this, yeah. That is the cause of dukkha. Yeah? Otherwise, you know, it's fine, yeah. We just live with the things that as they are. Because we don't want anything. But, you know, when the body gets sick, we want to become healthy again. Yeah? When our teeth rot away, you know, we want to go to the doctor, yeah? To fix it. Yeah? Because it's just constant pain. Yeah? So we don't want to fix it, yeah? We don't like this pain, so we don't see the dukkha, yeah? So see the dukkha, yeah? See the dukkha in your daily life. And realize, yeah? Wanting or not wanting that, we don't want pain, you know? So, yeah, we don't want the pain, you know, when we do sitting meditation. So that's why we get up. Or we change our position. We don't realize the dukkha, yeah? Dukkha can be a great motivation. But also, you know, reflecting about death. What is it, death? You know, what is coming after death? Huh? Another birth, but not the birth as a human being. Most of the time, yeah? In 99.9% of the cases, you know, we are not born as a human being again. Huh? Most of the human beings, you know, will go to hell. You know, just like the Lord Buddha said, they don't have any choice, yeah, but to go to hell. And some of us might go to heaven, yeah? But even in the heaven, you know, I mean, it is, yeah, I mean, you can enjoy the fruits of your good merit that you have done during your life, but once this merit is over, you know, I mean, you will have to face all the bad things that you have done in your life. They just don't go away. And the bad, and the thing that is not so comfortable to know is that we cannot exchange bad things with good things. We can't even that out. Yeah? We can't square it out. Remember that? I mean, with money, debt with good things, you know, I mean, we can square it out. Yeah, but the debt that we have through our bad karma that we did, we cannot square it out with good karma. So we sooner or later, we have to receive that bad karma because that karma comes back to us. Good karma comes back to us, bad karma comes back to us, and every moment of our daily routine we do karma. Do karma of thoughts, do karma of speech, and do karma of actions. That's why it's so dangerous. A human life is much more dangerous than any other life, yeah? Of course, the animal life is not easier, yeah? I mean, they do a lot of bad karma, yeah? Most of it, yeah? So, These are the two life forms, you know, I mean, that are really doing heavily karma. But the human life does the most heavily karma, yeah? Heavily karma in the sense of bad karma. But it can also do a heavily karma in the sense of good karma, yeah? So, before you do something, before you speak something, before you think something, know what you're doing and look at the results, you know, what do you expect from it? And when you did it, you know, or when you said it, you know, when you thought it, you know, look at the results and see if your expectations come true. Yeah? That's it. Huh? It's attentive, being attentive all the time, being aware of all the time. Every moment, from the moment we wake up until the moment, you know, we put our head on the pillow and fall asleep. No? I mean, what did the Lord Buddha advise us? You know, I mean, to even know. Remember that? We should know if we fall asleep with the Buddha, with the breath in or with the breath out. Huh? Oh, that is so difficult. Huh? That means this kind of attentiveness we need, this kind of awareness we need. It is, as I said before, you know, it is our flashlight. If the flashlight is is weak, we don't see things clearly. And even here in this life, you know, you do remember or please recall. Yeah, I mean, if you don't see clearly, you assume it is this or you assume it is that. Huh? And our assumptions, are of course for us are the truth, yeah. But they are still assumptions. Yeah? They have nothing to do with the truth. So I end with this, we don't really have any work to do. I mean most of our monastery is now in perfect condition, yeah. Except we need to repair this or repair that. I mean, there's no work going on. I can't think of anything, you know, in this year what needs to be done. So we can put all our attention on our practice. Yeah? It's your life. Yeah? You are responsible. Yeah? And I want, you know, I don't want to waste my energy in teaching you. Yeah? If I see nothing is happening.
I have one question from Joyce. It's possible.
With this, you have to come before. I've already done that.